Today I'm going to demo data analysis using Advanced Design System 2021. In the ADS data display, it's pretty easy to plot things and to make basic, plots and equations, but as the analysis gets larger, the data displays can become somewhat disorganized because there can be a lot of plots. In ADS 2020, we added this thing called the Expression Manager, which is a table of all the equations and traces in your entire data display, and you can sort everything in one place, so that's pretty nice. In ADS 2021, we expanded this Expression Manager to give users some powerful new ways to process simulation data. So here I've got a simulation for a filter, and I want to plot the results. These are just S parameters. I'll start by adding a plot for S11, and then what I'll do is duplicate this plot four times. I'm just copying and pasting to make a row. Now, using the Expression Manager, I just modify the other traces to give me the one-port S parameters. I'll just type in the expressions directly in the table. Next, I'll copy and paste that row three more times to make a 4x4 block. So what I want to do is convert this block to the S matrix. And to do that, I'll use the Search and Replace in Expression Manager. I'll select the second row, and I'll find the 1, comma part, and I'll replace that with a 2. And then I'll do the same thing for the third row. This time I'll select it, and I'll replace the 1 with a 3. And finally, for the fourth row, I'll replace the 1 with a 4. And now I've got the full S matrix plotted in pretty short order. So using this approach, you can quickly and efficiently generate a large set of plots, and you don't need to manually touch every one. I've got another simulation where I modified some of the filter values. So let's say I want to add those to the plots that I already have so I can compare the results. Now in the past, you would need to click on every single plot and add the new trace. But in ADS 2021, Expression Manager really simplifies things. All I need to do is just select the rows that I want using the Shift key, and then I right-click and I duplicate the traces. And this creates an identical set of traces on the plots. Next, what I'll do is point the duplicate traces to a new data set, which is corresponding to the modified filter. I just right-click and I go Change Data Sets, and that's it. I've got a set of plots now which directly compare these two S parameter cases. What if I want to change the color for the new traces? Again, in ADS 2021, all I need to do is select the set of traces, and I can right-click in bulk and change the color on all the traces at the same time. And it does it for all the plots that I want. And you can also, you can change the line type, you can change the symbol, the trace thickness, or the trace type. And by the way, you don't need to be an Expression Manager. You can do the same thing just by selecting multiple traces in your data display window, right-clicking and changing the settings. Another thing that happens as the data gets more complex is that you might use multiple equations to process data to make a plot. In ADS 2021, we've added a way to easily consolidate all of these equations into a standalone function. So here's an example. I'm processing simulation results for a transistor, and I'm generating power contours. Now, the final plot here uses inputs from multiple different equations to actually process the simulation data, and that makes it harder to do things like add a new data set if I wanted to add a new data set under a different condition to this plot. Well, in 2021, it's easy. I can actually take this equation and I can turn it into a function just by right-clicking and selecting Export to AEL function. And this function then automatically includes everything necessary to do this computation independently on a standalone basis. So the constants and dependent equations, these are wrapped into the body of the function, and the actual data set variables are grouped as inputs to the function, and that makes it portable. So just as an example, here's a parameter in the final equation. And I can trace this back through the lines in the function, and eventually what I get to is a raw input from the simulation data set. And that's actually what gets passed in at the top level of the function. So if I hit apply, this function gets loaded into my ADS session automatically. Now there are also options you can use to save the function as part of your workspace so you can share it with your colleagues, or you can configure the function to load with ADS when you open it. So it behaves almost like a built-in function inside of ADS. So now that I've got a single function to compute the contours, it's really easy to point that to a different data set. All I need to do is add this equation, which is calling this function, and then I can use the Expression Manager to automatically change the data set. And using that, I can add contours to a plot at, for example, a different frequency on the same chart, which consolidates all these multiple equations into one. Now, what I've shown you here are just a few ways that we've improved data analysis in ADS 2021. For more, check out the download page on the Keysight Knowledge Center.